Starting with Progress OpenEdge 11.7, OpenEdge RDBMS provides the Change Data Capture feature, or CDC. CDC identifies and captures data that has changed in tables of a source database as a result of create, update, and delete operations. This data can be exported to a data warehouse or business intelligence application. Change data is maintained in CDC data tables in the source database. These tables include a tracking table that maintains a record of all CDC activities and individual change tables for source tables with an active CDC policy. As an application developer, you're responsible for extracting CDC data. After you extract data from change tables, you should purge the data so that space in the change tables is freed up for reuse. Let's look at an example database, sports, with active CDC policies on two tables, customer and order. Let's assume the following. Sports has been configured as a managed database resource in OpenEdge Explorer, and sports is currently running. Let's take a look at CDC data for customer and order using Progress Developer Studio for OpenEdge. Look at the CDC change tracking table. This table tracks each create, update, or delete operation for a source table with an active CDC policy by a change sequence order. The CDC change tracking table contains two key fields, source table number, which contains a number for each source table, and change sequence, which indicates an operation's capture order within a specific change table. Note that there are a number of change tracking records associated with source table number 4. 4 indicates the customer table. There are also a number of change tracking records associated with source table number 13. 13 indicates the order table. Next, let's look at the change tables associated with customer and order. Like the CDC change tracking table, every change table has a change sequence field. All change tables are related to the CDC change tracking table through a foreign key relationship that uses change sequence. The customer change table is CDC customer, and the change sequence field in CDC customer is related to the change sequence field in CDC change tracking. Similarly, the order change table is CDC order, and the change sequence field in CDC order is related to the change sequence field in CDC change tracking. These foreign key relationships are used to extract and purge data from CDC customer and CDC order and related data from CDC change tracking. Let's look at how you purge CDC data. In this example, we will purge CDC data from the CDC change tracking table and the related change tables, CDC customer and CDC order. Let's assume that CDC records in CDC customer and CDC order have already been extracted but have not been purged. Note that for each record that has been extracted, the value processed has been entered in the user MISC field. This way, any records that are added after the extraction but before the purging will not be purged. There are two ways you can purge CDC data in OpenEdge ABL. The first way is to use an ABL Helper class. The ABL Helper class has a number of important advantages. For example, when you iterate through the CDC change tracking table, it will automatically purge the record in this table and the related records in the associated change table. The ABL Helper class does this by using the foreign key relationship between the CDC change tracking table and the specific change table. The ABL Helper class is called CDC Tracking Helper. One of its methods is delete change tracking record, which is used to purge CDC data. Let's look at a code example that uses the CDC Tracking Helper class. We define a variable based on the helper class. Then we define an integer variable to hold the file number of the source table, and a character variable to hold the name of the source table. Next, we enter a repeat block. In this block, we find a CDC change tracking record that has been marked processed. Using this record, we look up the file number of the source table. Next, we use the file number of the source table to look up the name of the source table. Then we use the name of the source table to create a CDC tracking helper object for the source table using the CDC change tracking buffer. We then assign to the helper class variable this CDC tracking helper object. Next, we iterate through the CDC change tracking table where the source table number matches the CDC tracking helper variable. We then invoke the delete change tracking record method from the helper class to delete all change tracking records and related change records for that source table. We then loop back to purge CDC data from the CDC change tracking table and the related change table. Once we have purged all processed data, the repeat block ends. Now let's run this program. As you can see, tracking records from the CDC change tracking table have been purged. Related CDC customer and CDC order change records have also been purged. The second way you can purge CDC data in OpenEdge ABL is to write your own code that does not use the CDC tracking helper class. However, if you choose to do this, you have to loop through the CDC change tracking table to delete the tracking records. You will also have to manually look up the name of each change table and then explicitly delete the records from those tables. Note that when CDC is set up in the source database, OpenEdge provides a number of CDC levels that determine how much CDC data is captured. Levels range from minimal to maximum. If you have a source table that has a minimal CDC level, no change table is created for the source table. Because of this, you only need to purge CDC data in the CDC change tracking table for that source table. Another advantage of the CDC tracking helper class is that it will handle this for you. But if you write your own code, you have to handle it yourself. You have now learned how to purge CDC data after it has been extracted. To learn more about the CDC Tracking Helper class, see the Progress OpenEdge 11.7 guide, Programming Interfaces.